picked up by the police. When she called him, she was like, you got to go finish the deal. That's what she was talking about. You got to close the deal. You know what I'm saying? Close the deal, you know, we can move forward. I can go on here and get in with the guy. Because I thought when she paid the last episode, when she was saying we need to do it a different way, and they brought into the, they paid a big lump sum for the, I guess, the little dinner or whatever, donation or whatever. I thought that was to the mayor, but it was actually saying got his attention, was he's a real estate investor. So I thought he was a mayor when they first walked. And I'm like, he the mayor?
Yeah. I like, this thing got a big ass house for a mayor.
Mayor or something, like I ain't know what he was doing. Then he like, then she started talking, he'd been doing the real estate investment. So yeah, so he looked like he into that scandalous shit too. He might be some shite.
Yeah. You know that nigga that, you know, you see that nigga in any show. So, that nigga is shiesty, bro.
He's in the shy. Man,
yeah. Yeah. That nigga like the actor Leon. Anytime you see that nigga, don't trust that nigga, bro. Like, I don't know any movie that nigga played. Don't trust that nigga right there, bro. You know that nigga's not the one to be trusted, bro.
Real, man. For real, bro. So, yeah, that finessing was cold-blooded, bro. I was like, man. But I think they got to worry about the dirty cop, though. Now he done got kicked off the beat. He ain't got the whip no more. He ain't out in the streets. He can get down and get dirty now, you know what I'm saying? Because he know what Franklin into, you know what I'm saying? He already got them dirty cops on his team. So he probably really going to be really feeling spiteful now to kind of go shake him down and do more stuff to him because they know what the deal is now, especially when they get him kicked off. I ain't going to say he didn't get kicked off the force, but he kind of got, he's like, because he walked in, like, man, I don't know who you pissed off or what you did.
Yeah.
You off the float, you off the beat. You know what I'm saying? You going down to evidence lockup. And he just went back to start working. Like, look, I don't know. Like, I ain't even getting involved in this.
Then told that nigga Chase up, we go press charges. Then you better get your ass out of here. Cause you know what I mean?
And the guy got some pull, bro. The real estate investor got some. He's like, man, that cop issue you got, oh, it's already taken care of. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Taken care of. So yeah, the boy got pulled.
Hey, the cop gone. But I think they gonna get rid of the cop though. He gonna, like you said, I think he gonna come down, try to. I'm like, bro, Franklin already done shot your partner, man. Like, he'll get you out of there too. And then he done, if I was the cop, I'd leave Franklin alone. After he done got me kicked off the beat, I'd be like, look, he done killed my partner, got me kicked off. Man, let's leave this nigga alone, bro.
He was already getting that, what, even $20,000 a week or whatever he getting, $10,000 a week. Could have just stuck with that, but now he want to be greedy. You know, double my, you know what I'm saying? Double it. All right, you want to double it? Okay.
Yeah, then running his house, mess with his mama, throw his mama off, beat his mama, you know what I mean? Beat his mama up.
You don't do nobody the family like that, bro.
Man, you know what I mean? Drop her off at some, in the mortuary, yeah, I mean, in the funeral, I mean, yeah, graveyard. Man, come on, bro.
Stop it, bro. You can cut it out. So yeah, he played it up. And that's called being, he having too many emotions wrapped up in the whole situation. He ain't thinking it through. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. He could have been easily pressing, you know what I'm saying, Franklin in other ways to get his money instead of trying to go to that route. You know, you playing with a man's family, it gonna go, you know, he gonna be with the extreme. You know, he ain't about to kill him, but he moving different ways. So you already know it's coming your way.
Oh, you know it's coming. Then you got your other partner. His partner, whoever the white dude is, pull a gun out there in his house.
Yeah, bro. Bruh,
I'm like, man, hey, Franklin's like, okay, we about to see what it is now.
Yeah,
that man in the office, close the door. You know what I mean? I said, it's a wrap for buddy now. It's a wrap.
He like, cause he told me, like, man, you had me 4 months ago, but you took the money, bro. Like, when you took that bread, everything changed. You dirty, man.
Dirty. Hey, Franklin told him, hey, you took the money, so shut the fuck up.
Bro, you dirty. You dirty now. Once you take the bread, what you gonna say? All you gotta do is, he took the money. What you gonna do?
Man, like you said, he should've just, like you said, closed his mouth and start, kept taking the money.
Kept getting
He want to get tough because he sent it over there to handle Scully. He got scared or whatever. Him and his partners didn't want to run off from there.
He like, man, I gave you a job, dude, man. That's all. You know what I'm saying? I ain't trying to set you up. I gave you a job, dude. That's like, that ain't my problem.
That ain't my fault. All you have to do is say no. We keep doing what we doing.
Keep it moving. Keep it pushing. But nah, you want to get greedy, extra bands, then go get your board. They like, nah, bro. They got the whole block sold up. They got the car in the thing in case somebody pull up and go knock the truck. And he got all the men's around the whole building. Like, nah, bro.
Yeah. Told that nigga, don't come at me with this bullshit. See, man, you see all the motherfuckers in there? Come on, man. We're going to need the whole police force up here to come.
I ain't going to jungle like that. It's a, like what Denzel was like, we open the jungle.
Up in the jungle, bro. We not going to. You see them niggas over there? Niggas got trucks in them. Call what do you call it? They got the rammer. That's the rammer right there, just in case you. Man, niggas up in there got like Great Wall of China in that motherfucker, man.
Bro, say we ain't going up in. That's the jungle, bro. I ain't going up in the jungle.
Man, yeah. So then Franklin though, he gonna have to resolve something. He gonna have to stop somebody. Either the cop. He gonna have to get him out of there. Definitely gonna have to get Scully out of there. Or Man Boy. He probably gonna end up having to get Man Boy too, because Man Boy gonna come for him. Man Boy gonna come for his spot. And he might have to take all three of them boys out. The cop, Scully, and Man Boy at the end of the day. Now, I ain't said all at one time, yeah, but at different times he gonna have to get at him.
Cause you got problems with all of them, bro. You're gonna have problems with all of them, bro. The longer it go, the more it fails, the more chance you're gonna get a chance to get. Cause he just be riding around with just that one guy. And I'm like, bro, you out here a target, bro. You can't be moving.
Target, bro.
He's just moving, just pulling up with, you know what I'm saying? Pulling up in front of people's stores and stuff like this by yourself, just you and the guy.
Yeah, bro. Like who's nigga you walking around with? This nigga Blade or something? This nigga get shot too, can't he? Like
for real, bro. I'm like, bro, you're a target out here in these streets, man. It's a war going on. You out here just riding around with your little cane in the car. You ain't got no pistol, nothing to protect yourself.
Nigga can barely walk, man. Like, what's wrong with you, bro? Yeah. You can barely walk, bro, over here walking around with just one bald head nigga.
He ain't switching cars. He ain't doing nothing. Cause like they keep showing that one scene. Like I guess they keep showing that one scene when they all pull up on him. You know, while he's sitting still, and they shoot up in the car. You know, they keep showing that one scene. You know, I guess like a preview for it coming up.
Yeah.
I'm like, y'all boys, y'all got to be switching cars. They ain't switching cars because you got Jerome. He just got the beat in the whip, so he driving the same whip everywhere he go.
That nigga Jerome, but and my thing is like, bro, what made you want to move back to your mom and dad crib? You know what I mean?
I think his mom probably did that when he got them three slugs. She probably made him come back to the crib so she can take care of him. Cause you know he had the house. Cause you know they had the house on the hill, but they, you know what I'm saying, the police went ramshacked.
Yeah, bro.
They found out
he ain't supposed to be living there. He ain't supposed to be in there with his.
Not on the block, bro. You can't be on the block. You can't be the head honcho living at your mom's crib on the block like that. They know where you at.
So where you at, bro? You ain't got no soldiers outside. Ain't like you got soldiers outside. You know what I mean? At least at Jerome's house. Remember, Jerome used to have the soldiers on the porch.
Yeah, had them boys on the porch, you know what I'm saying? Letting them know, like, look, this is how it's going down. But, you know, he trying to move differently. You know what I mean? Look at, bro, you got to get out the city, man. When you slanging that mother dope, you the head honcho, bro, you can't be seen.
At all.
You can't
at
be
at all.
Seen. It's just like, mm-hmm. When you go to the doctor's office, man, you can't go talk right straight to the doctor. You got to go talk to the nurse. You got to talk to that nurse, get blood pressure checked. You got to go
You got to check in first at the desk.
Yeah, you gotta go sit in the long room by yourself. Then he come see you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. They put you in the room first, and then you sit in the room by yourself. Then he come in. Hey, what's happening? You know what I mean?
So if it's hard enough to get to the doctor, it should be hard. Like E4, so you gotta make it hard on these boys when they trying to get at you, man. You gotta make it hard on them.
Man, make it hard. Yeah. Nigga come walking around with that big ass beeper. Nigga, you better have a cell phone. Nigga, back in the day, you better have the brick. Man, Franklin be tripping, man.
I think this probably before the brick cell phone, the long brick cell phone. I think it was right before.
Okay, it might be. You might be right. You might be right.
Because that brick was what, like 95, 4, something like that?
Yeah, probably about. Was it? I want to say.
92, 95?
Yeah, probably. I want to say about 92. No. You know what? Before the brick phone, remember they had the car phone. They had the one inside the car.
Yeah, yep, they did.
Man, he supposed to have something like that, bro. Just, hey, come, hey, you know, like,
yeah.
You had to pick that thing up, you know. But yeah, Franklin,
it'd be a whole bag.
Bro, Franklin be walking around like he, my man, Pablo, like he owned whole Medellin. You know, Pablo, he owned the whole country, so he could walk around like, nigga, what you about to do? I'm like, come on, Franklin, bro, you don't even own your block, nigga. Like, you supposed to ride around in the bulletproof, what they had back in there, bulletproof Bronco or something. You know what I mean?
Even when Pablo was back there in the street, you never saw Pablo. He had so many stash houses. It was going crazy.
going crazy. That pop up fucking around, be under the tunnels and shit, moving around.
He in this spot one time, and next spot he in another spot, another city, another spot. And Franklin just at his mom crib every day, just posted up on the block
every day.